Hello, friends. I'm so ready for us to create our background. And the first step to creating the background is using chalk. The first thing you need to do is write your first and last name on your paper. And this will be the back. So when you write your name, turn it to the front. And we want to turn our paper horizontal because we're making a landscape. Most pieces of artwork that are landscapes are best horizontal. So please don't turn your paper like this. That would be vertical. This is nice and tall, but we want it short and wide like this, okay? And you're gonna be given a choice today. You're either gonna be using mostly warm colors, which are reds, oranges, yellows. Today, the pinks that you have will be warm colors as well, or the cool colors, which would be blues, greens, and purples, okay? So here's one that's all finished with the trees and everything, and you can see that the background is the warm color. So the back, if you want your sky to look more like daytime and bright and sunny, you might be choosing the warm colors, like the pinks and the oranges, the reds, and the yellows. If you want it to look more nighttime or a more peaceful, cool, and calm, you might want to choose the cool colors, blues, greens, and violets, okay? I already did the warm colors, so I'm going to show you with the cool colors, but either one you choose, you're going to follow the same directions. We want to stay away from grays. We want to stay away from whites. So I'm going to take them out. You don't take them out of your tray. I'm just going to get them out of the way so you remember not to use them. If you're using the warm colors, we're gonna stay away from browns, okay? And the one that looks a little like a gold, but the peach would be fine because it's very close to these warm colors, okay? So no browns, no golds, no grays, no whites, okay? But you can use all the rest. These are called chalk pastels. Chalk pastels are very messy, but I'm gonna show you a special way to keep them clean and not so dusty, okay? What you're gonna do is you're just gonna color patches of color, just like that, and you're gonna skip around your paper, okay? And you're gonna experiment using different techniques. So you might wanna draw some curved patches of color. You might wanna draw some zigzag patches of color, okay? And after you do one color, switch to another from your tray, okay? And just experiment using different colors and different directions. You might want to make one go this way. You might want to do a wavy type color. And it looks like I'm scribbling, doesn't it? Don't worry. I will show you how to make it look like a beautiful painted background. I'm not mixing these chalks together. I'm just coloring little patches. And what I'm doing now with this green is I'm going in between the white. I don't want to color my entire paper. I just want to color most of it so that when you see white patches, it's just a little bit, okay? I'll tell you now, the more chalk you use, the more colorful it is going to be and the more it'll look like a painted masterpiece instead of a chalk drawing or a chalk coloring, okay? Once you do lots of coloring with your patches, I'm gonna do this side a little later, but I'm gonna take a little break so I can show you what's gonna start to happen. You're also gonna be given a cup of liquid starch, okay? It looks like that. At first it looks like glue or maybe water, like cloudy water, but liquid starch is actually something that some people use to iron their clothes to make them nice and straight, but we're using them for something very different today, of course. So you're gonna choose one finger, usually your pointer finger is what I want you to use, and even though it has chalk on it, it's okay because this is yours, and you're going to dip a little, just your fingertip, okay, into the starch, okay, one time. And then if I were you, I would start way on one side and at the top, okay? And then you're going to rub it on top of the chalk. And as you do that, lots of things happen. First of all, your chalk turns into this paint-like consistency, okay? Also, the colors mix together. That's why it's important for you to color your patches close together and not have a whole lot of white space, okay? When your finger runs out of starch, you get some more and keep going. And continue to rub the colors together. You are not doing this and rubbing the whole thing. You're only rubbing little patches together, okay? When your finger kind of gets scratchy and like it feels rough and scratchy, that's another signal that you need more starch. So when it gets dry and scratchy and it doesn't glide across the paper, you need more starch. You can practice using circles. You can practice using curved lines. You can experiment doing different things. So remember, when you're using your chalk, the more chalk you use, the more color you're going to have when you use the starch, okay? If you don't use a lot of chalk, if I didn't use a lot of chalk, I would see all this very light and white, and I don't want that. I want lots of the colors to show through. So it's gonna be a lot more colorful the more chalk you use, okay? Remember, you can make big sweeping motions, not too big, because you don't wanna go over the whole thing, okay? You wanna keep it in one area. Or you can do circles if you want it to look more like, I don't know, maybe like a windy effect, okay? Or you can do, and you can do both. You can experiment with something new, okay? You could do little zigzags and see how that looks. And you could, this is experimenting, so if you see something that looks really cool, you can do it on other parts of your paper or switch to something else, okay? Now, the only rule that I have is that the starch goes on top of the chalk only. Do not put starch on top of the white paper without having chalk first. And do not color the chalk on top of the wet starch, okay? So all this is wet. You can tell I have a little area that hasn't been mixed up because it looks different. It just looks like coloring. It doesn't look like paint, so I'm gonna keep going. And then I'm gonna stop before I get starch on the white paper. I don't wanna do that. I wanna keep my paper dry so I can do the rest, okay? If you're switching a lot from chalk to starch, because you can do a little bit of chalk, a little bit of starch, a little bit of chalk, a little bit of starch. You can clean your hands with a baby wipe. All right, now I'm gonna use another cool color. Remember, no blacks, no grays, no browns, and no golds. And I'm gonna color little patches. I didn't use purple yet. I think I'm gonna just create a big old wavy line like that. Also, the chalk is really dusty. You may feel like blowing it off or sweeping it off, but please don't do either. Leave it there because all this dust will turn your starch, mix with your starch and turn into a really cool paint, remember? So you don't wanna sweep or blow off the dust. Okay, you don't wanna color on top of each other. You wanna leave a little bit of space in between. Remember, more chalk, the more colorful it's gonna be. And I can use a color that I used before, or I can experiment with a new color. Remember, little patches of color, but you can experiment doing different lines. Okay? Now, most of my paint is covered in chalk, right? I only have a little bit of white spot, so what does that mean? I'm ready for the starch, okay? Remember, one fingertip, and I'm gonna start right here where I left off, and I'm gonna even push some of my purple to my green so that it'll mix with my green. Remember, you do not wanna do this and mix it all together at once. You only wanna mix similar colors or together. You see how, remember how I made that big old wavy line with the purple? I wanna continue that line with my starch, so I did do a big area, but I didn't mix everything together. I just kind of stuck with the purple and the color that was next door, okay? All right, I'm gonna continue this and speed it up while you watch, and then you can do this on your own. Here's another technique I played around with. I thought, I wonder what it would look like if I colored in circular
patches. And then when using the liquid starch, I use my finger to do circles. Experiment with different types of techniques.